Good evening. I am Miika and this is my daughter Isabella.
Hi.
Today we are going to explain to you how this prototype of our newest robot works. We are going to need some kind of an ordinary computer and this Arduino IDE program in order to program this our microcontroller. If your computer doesn't yet have that Arduino IDE software, see the beginning of the video number 10 on how to install one into your computer. But otherwise, you should be able to do a similar robot for yourself after watching this video. No other preliminary skills will be needed. So, welcome to join us today.
Let's first take a look at the robot itself. If one of these buttons is being pressed, this Arduino Uno microcontroller gives commands to this motor driver board. The motor driver is able to make our big stepper motor to rotate clockwise and counterclockwise. And those rotations make that little wagon to drive back and forth. That stepper motor model 17HD4416-03N comes from the manufacturer Moons and it costs less than $10 at AliExpress. All the other items that we use today we have bought from eBay. This Adafruit V2 Motor Shield clone costs there about $6. This Arduino Uno clone costs about $3. And this tiny keyboard costs less than $1. The four wires that come from the motor are easy to connect. This brown and this red wire go to this pair of screw terminals that is marked as M3 at the motor driver board. You may choose to connect any of those two wires to this leftmost screw terminal. After that, the other wire naturally goes to that second screw terminal. And respectively, I connect the blue and the orange wires to this M4 terminal. This stepper motor presents only four wires, so I leave the middlemost screw terminal unused. The +6 volt wire from our power source goes to this screw terminal on the left. And the ground wire goes to the one on the right. This particular motor needs such a 6 volt power source that it's able to deliver up to about 1.6 amperes of current. These two power sources won't do at all, as the intelligent battery chargers don't give any continuous output power and as our ordinary batteries are meant for much smaller currents. But we could continue using that 6 volt transformer or use an old-fashioned battery charger or experiment a while with this small motorcycle battery. In the beginning of this video, our power source served simultaneously both the stepper motor and the Arduino Uno board. In that practical solution, the electric noise that comes from the motor can disturb or even mix up the function of a microcontroller. We can avoid that by removing this connector and by using some other power source for the microcontroller. Arduino Uno shields are very practical, as you may place them directly onto the microcontroller boards. And, as said earlier, our Arduino Uno also should listen to these four buttons. Let's power up the Arduino Uno and the motor shield. I now double-click this icon of the Arduino IDE program that my dad has installed in the video number 10. I choose Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries. I search for V2 and I click this box of Adafruit Motor Shield V2 Library. If that library isn't yet installed into your computer, you can get it by clicking this install button. And finally, we may click this close button. Then I choose Tools, Port, and there I select the USB serial port that our computer has today assigned for this particular Arduino Uno. Now I choose File, Examples, Adafruit Motor Shield V2 Library, Stepper Test, and there I choose Sketch, Upload, and after that uploading, our stepper motor starts rotating back and forth. I measured approximately 1 ampere's continuous current flowing through the motor, and the motor gets quite warm. Luckily, these two motor driver chips don't seem to get very hot, so I don't need to put these heat sinks onto them. Let's modify that example program a little. Here, I declare that always when a button is not being pressed down, its signal is considered to be high. And this command line here was responsible for the quick rotation that our motor made. With this additional command, I can make those rapid rotation to continue as long as the button of the pin number 13 is being pressed down. I also want that the status of that button is to be checked after every single tiny step of rotation. And here we get the same action to take place, but to the opposite direction, as long as the button of the pin number 10 is being pressed down. These lines made the fairly slow modes of rotations that we saw. I hide those lines behind these command markings as we don't need today those slowish rotation modes anymore. And let's hide these lines too, as we don't today make use of the serial monitor either. But I want to get these most precise microstep rotation modes to take place always when I press the buttons that are connected to the pins number 12 and 11. I now choose Sketch, Upload, and start pressing those four buttons, and our robot makes exactly the actions that we want. If I delete all the command lines, we see that the actual program isn't long at all. Stepper motors are precise, but they can't rotate at a very fast speed. Anyhow, if we increase this number up to about 200 or 250 and choose again Sketch, Upload, we can make our motor to run 4 or 5 times quicker. If you became interested in those mechanical parts that we were using here, or if you want deeper insight into the motor shield, or into the library that we use, see further description below this video. Take care, goodbye.
Bye bye.